Okay, let's start with a new album.
Let's.
Yeah. Seems like a great starting
exactly.
point.
Exactly, I think so as well. Is it good?
Well, I mean, we'd like to think so. We've worked on it now for a fair few months, and we've really enjoyed making it. That's like our second favourite process, second to performing, I guess. Mm-hmm. And we, in particular, we literally travelled the world to make this album, which is interesting, on our time off, so we really hope you guys enjoy it. It's nice.
What is fun about that work? Because to me, it sounds like the most worky part of it, if you get what I mean.
Well, in a sense, I mean, that with the travel and different things, that's the most difficult part of it, and giving up time off. But once you get in the studio and you're hanging out with your mates, and like, there's a lot of work that goes on, but it's also a lot of fun and chit chat. But then at the end of the day, you always come out with a great thing that wasn't there before.
Yeah.
So that's like the most fun part now, I guess. It's like hanging out with your mates, but also working. Which is every day.
Do you argue anything in the studio?
There's been arguments between. Yeah. We never. Remember that big argument that kicked off between Julie and Jamie and John, and that we watched it for a little bit, and then we thought, about time we joined in, really, hadn't it? So then we joined in this argument with these producers. It was over the words "it" or "you."
Yeah.
That's how important that argument was. Okay.
But it's important to have those conversations in the studio, isn't it?
Because even if it is about "it" or "you."
Even if it is about "it" or "you," yeah.
If you would sell me this album, if you would pitch it to me.
We are.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
We're trying. Like,
if you
we're
would
trying.
Pitch it even harder. Keep in mind, I'm a 35-year-old white guy from Sweden.
I'll tell you. You should. I actually think there's a lot more from different eras than people realise of music they might have enjoyed in the past.
Influences.
Hidden in this album that influenced us to make it. Because although, you know, we were born in the 90s, we actually go way back in time with our music making quite a lot. And, you know, it's kind of mixing it up with the current thing. So my advice to anybody would be just give it a listen. Give it one listen. If you don't like it, you can burn it, smash it, put on it, whatever the hell you want to do. But give it one listen.
That's interesting.
Boom!
yeah, poo on it, sold it hard.
Poo on it. Shit on it.
I'm going to buy it. Absolutely.
You have to, right?
Yeah, I know. But I got one.
Right. You might get it free.
Yeah, that's
right. Yeah, if you're nice.
But the funny thing is, when you talk like that, it's interesting because I heard the song History.
Nice.
Which
what did
exactly,
you think?
I loved it.
Really?
Yeah, I really loved it. Good. Because I think it's a very different sound from what we might be used to from you guys, but it's also a sound that has a lot of flirting with older material from like the almost 70s, 80s.
Yeah, for sure. Like I say, I mean, there's one song I made ages ago, which actually is the reason for this tattoo, that goes way, way back in time, that went a bit too back in time. It's when everyone had gone to bed and I was left alone with John and Julian. When I wrote that Man on a Mission tune,
we
wrote the second verse, and it was just a bit too old for the album at the moment. So that song's never even been heard. But that we do like to go back in time with things.
Yeah, we try to.
And what would you say is your biggest challenge right now? Do you see it like that at all as a challenge?
I think obviously you feel with the new record coming out, you obviously feel the pressure. And for us, we've got such a fantastic and dedicated fan base that, you know, with that you really want to impress them and you really want them to be happy with what we've done. Yeah. So you kind of just live with that pressure, and that's why around this time, just before the album comes out, you do have those kind of nervy nights, but hopefully we'll be okay.
Yeah, of course you will. But you're four guys now. Is it a different 1D?
Well, yeah, for sure, definitely different, but I mean, not in a good way or a bad way, just different, really,
just
I guess.
Yeah.
You know, it was a difficult time, and it's always difficult. I've been saying this all day, but to lose a member of any team, I think, is the best description you could say. Like, if it was somebody working in an office and someone was leaving, you'd be sad, you know, as long as you like them. And you know, we got on well with Zane, so it's like, you know, it's his decision in the end, and he made it for the right reasons for himself. If he didn't feel he could do this anymore and wanted to take a break and do something himself, that's absolutely fine. You know, everyone deserves the right to do so, and you know, we wish him the best of luck, and thanks to our beautiful fans, we've managed to continue, carry on touring, and made a whole new album, even after he left. So, you know, a lot of bands don't get the chance to do that when they lose a member. That's usually game over, but our fans thought something different.
Yeah, it really is credit to the fans.
Yeah, hugely, man. Like, we when he first left, we obviously were nervous and worried, like, what's going to happen next? And then, you see the reaction, and it was really nice.
It was really lovely, yeah.
And what do you... Have you guys ever felt like that? Like you want to, oh, I mean, you've been doing this for 5 years, almost.
You know, I think there's days. I think there's days when you can get angry and upset like that. Once again, happens in any form of life, any job that you do. So, I wouldn't say you would ever wish it away, but there's times when you thought, you know what, I would like to just go home and put my feet up for a little bit, I guess.
Mm, yeah.
But you know, you have to persevere sometimes.
Yeah, I think it takes
and
it.
The fans are also, like, if I'm having a bad day before we go on stage or something's happened or, you know, I've had an argument with my missus, whatever it might be, the moment you step foot on that stage, it all goes away and that you're just lost in that moment for the next 2 hours mm-hmm. of performing and making people smile.
And now you declare that you're going to take a break?
Oh, yeah.
Well, first of the day.
But what would you say would be the step after that? Because I think that's the question. On you made a lot of people nervous taking this break. A lot of people always
surprising.
Which, if you think about it, a lot of other bands and especially like touring bands will you know spend maybe 2 years making the album, then like 2 years of touring, and then maybe a 2 year break. And actually, what we're doing isn't that. Weird. What's more weird is the fact that we've been lucky enough to do 5 albums in 5 years and so many tours in such a short space of time, which is why I think it is like alarming to people. Mm. But as far as we're concerned, there's nothing to worry about, and we've pledged that we're coming back, which we are.
Mm. I actually
so,
think
no beef.
I actually think musically it's an exciting time for us because our albums usually get made in a short space of time compared to what most bands do. So actually, I think the fans should be more excited about the idea of us having time to make different music, because I'm sure when we come back to it in a year, 2 years' time, we'll all have a bunch of songs and go, I've got stuff for the new album. And then that stuff will have been made over a long period of time. So I think it's going to make a different album for us as well. So it's exciting.
What are you going to do?
Spend a lot of time with the family, see friends, all pretty normal stuff, spend time in our houses.
Yeah.
Little road trips, maybe.
Little PlayStation.
Oh,
plenty
yeah.
Of PlayStation, plenty of PlayStation, plenty of FIFA, all that.
Plenty of that.
We spoke about going on holiday, didn't we?
Yeah, we spoke about going on like
all
a lad's holiday.
Just pretty normal stuff. And in terms
of songwriting.
Other than that, really, in terms of work, we've not really thought that far ahead because we're just excited at the prospect of having a bit of time off, you know.
Yeah, it is. I think for us though, because we're such like working people, like we love to work as well. It will be difficult. So I think I can imagine us two doing a lot of songwriting, and you've got your label thing going on. So yeah, there's loads to do, man.
Yeah.
Might do a puzzle.
Yeah, you could do a puzzle or a
few. Should. Yeah. You should actually do just that.
Do a massive puzzle.
Just to calm everyone down, this is of course not a break. It is a break, but it's not a break up.
Yes.
And when will you see you again? Because people are going to miss you guys. You know
well,
that?
I mean, we haven't put a date on it because, you know, you kind of don't want to have a date on your time off sort of thing. So, you know, we want people to feel comfortable to come back and start up again. When everyone's good and ready, I guess, which I don't think will be too long. I imagine it being a lot shorter than people think.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Because you're going to miss this as soon as we leave, and we know that going into the break, all of us, so we know how valuable and how exciting and how lucky we are to be in this position. So, you know, 100% we're going to come back. It's just a little bit of time for us at the moment, which I think, you know, we appreciate that a lot of the fans who tweet about saying, you know, the guys do need a break to, you know, live their lives, is that's really nice.
Yeah.
We're out of time, but guys, I want to thank you for do you remember we took a selfie on the stage in Stockholm?
Yeah, in Stockholm,
We had like 20,000 new followers.
Now we're
happy
talking.
Days.
I know.
Winning.
Yeah, thanks.
Start advertising.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I got to run back.
Okay, yeah.
Go for it.
See you guys.
See you. Thank you very much. Thank you, mate. Thank you.
Thanks, Ross. Thank you very much,
good
man.
To see you again.